Hi YouTube family, so this is just a quick introduction video to the following, what's coming behind it. I finally did a spasticity video. They're hard to catch because my spasms are the worst in the morning. So we did the best that we could and we had a third person here today to record while grandma had to yank and pull. Not yank and pull, but she just has to use all her strength because I'm really strong. So I hope you enjoy this one. It's short and sweet and to the point. My legs put on a show. You almost got a real show. Thank goodness you didn't. Because I lost my sheet in part of the video. But you asked and I answered. I hope you enjoy it.
Okay. Ooh.
He's already doing it.
We'll see if we can get my arms. So good last night.
Whoa, whoa.
Careful, Graham.
They're doing a good job there.
They were so good last night. They were straight. When you turn me over, that never happened.
Okay, that's probably all you're going to get.
I know, we're probably going to have to pull me up.
Yeah.
Okay, Susan, you can.
That's good.
Good for now.
Part one and part two. Like one after the other on TV.
Okay, that's good. Right. I might have you shut off the bright light.
Mm-hmm.
Shut off
okay.
The bright one.
Because we've got the. Yeah, they're fine. You can see it's my feet. If I need to lighten it, I can.
Okay.
There's really no point in me meditating with the bright light in my face.
All right. I don't be long.
Oh, good. It's good. It's perfect. You can see my feet, which is perfect.
But I don't want
to
be in it.
You're not going to be in it. Just pull my foot. I won't even be able to see you. I'll see your hands and maybe your glasses. Thank you. Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. The 60th Grammy Awards are on tonight. I'm rooting for Despacito to win Record of the Year. It's been pretty cold lately, but Luis Fonsi's summer hit reminds me of warmer times and warmer climes. Ask me for another Grammy prediction, and I'll help you start your day on a high note.
Alexa, daily affirmation.
Here is your affirmation for today. My body is healthy, my mind is brilliant, my soul is tranquil.
Alexa, play my daily devotion.
Hello there. Would you like the daily devotion?
Yes.
Friends in a World of Hurt. Bible reading, 2 Corinthians 1:3-7. When others are troubled, we will be able to give them the same comfort God has given us. 2 Corinthians 1:4. Here's some tough news. Scan any crowd of kids and you'll see pain all around you. You're almost guaranteed to see people struggling with broken friendships, a serious illness, the death of a friend or family member, or a strained situation at home. You can be sure they face the losses and disappointments of everyday life, earning a bad grade, losing a library book, or being cut from a team. So what can you do to ease the pain and hurt? You're on the right track if any of these ideas flutter through your brain. Be available. Speak encouraging words. Pray for your friend. Do acts of kindness. Point your friend to helpful scripture passages. All of those responses are great. Yet God has one more way to use you to ease the grief or trouble of a hurting friend. Maybe you can understand it best through this illustration. Suppose you love to skateboard, yet one day you prove the most basic law of science, what goes up must come down. And even though you soar into the air when you hit the jump and get 3 whole seconds of hang time, you rudely slam to the ground. Take a vote, when your best friend rushes to your side to cheer you up, Which of the following responses would make you feel better? A. Your friend zonks and goes to sleep while you're talking. B. Your friend tells you how dumb you were and how dumb skateboarding is. C. Your friend gets steaming mad and threatens to sue the guy who sold you the skateboard. D. Your friend listens carefully, then says something like, I'm sorry this happened to you. I feel bad that you are hurting. I'm here for you, dude. If you went for that last option, you have a good idea how God wants to involve you in bringing comfort to a hurting friend. Romans 12:15 encourages you to share the sorrow of those who feel sad. When you identify with the pain and hurt of a friend speaking kind words and showering your friend with care, God miraculously reduces your friend's pain. And that's a Christ-like thing to do. Talk. Who around you is hurting? What can you do about this? Pray. God, give us opportunities to heal the sadness of others by sharing the pain. Ask. Scan that crowd of hurting people around you. Plan to help someone today by offering comfort. 28 Jan.
Thank you.